This is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
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 This is a dangerous groups that we're dealing with now.
We live in a time where just standing on basic rights is heroic because we're all so used to giving them up day to day that like when somebody comes forward and says, no, we have these rights and I'm going to stand on them and I'm going to be unwavering. This has now become heroic. This has become, like the founder said, telling the truth in a world full of lies is a revolutionary act, right? I'm not one of these folks like they claim who wants to overthrow government. I understand spiritually government would only be necessary for a population of folks who have proven they cannot govern themselves based on natural law and God's law. And that's exactly what we have. So I'm a proponent of folks who are able to govern themselves, who understand the foundational principles of the law of this land, that they be left alone. They say these are the most dangerous folks on the land. Why? Because they're talking and standing on what they're saying. They're not doing nothing to nobody. They're just revealing to everyone we have God-given rights and they're willing to stand on them and die for them. And that's the most dangerous man on the planet right now. Right now, the rest of the slaves, the ones who self-identify as trustees, whether they know it or not, part of the United States federal corporation, federal body politic, they have a duty and obligation through contract to uphold the policies and codes. Because now, again, there's two classes of being. There's a privileged class of being under the law, and then there's a protected class of being. Most of us have opted into being a privileged class where we get privileges and benefits in exchange for essentially our rights by contract. So majority of folks are entering into a contract. They have made themselves a part of a corporate body politic, and therefore they have an obligation to fulfill that contract. If they want to correct that status and that standing and that presentment, and therefore renegotiate on that contract, right, and go back to being a man or woman on the land, then they're not subject to policy and code. They're only subject to the law of the land and essentially God's law, right? A set of laws that's in our conscience. It's discoverable. We can come to know it and do it, and we will create a kingdom of heaven out of that. But because we do not seek the truth and be set free, we are born into a certification program where a legal person is created, an all caps entity is created, and we spend the first 18 years identifying as that entity everywhere we go, taking our birth certificate and our social security down to DMV, getting ourselves a license for a right we already have. A license is synonymous with doing business and commerce. At a certain point, they created a group, a corporate capacity, where everybody opts into in order to be kept safe, right? This is sort of the movement of the idea, in my mind, of the republic into a demosocracy, where, okay, you identify as this member of the corporate body politic, you're agreeing that you want to be kept safe. And we see this now, where folks are going to their government to be kept safe and being given benefits and privileges. You have a split now, bifurcation, where the republic has now become a demosocracy in a lot of people's minds. There is no more faith structure. There is no more family structure. The state has essentially been moved in as our cosmic parents on every level. They've taught us through the public schooling system funded by the state that we need them. And if you don't accept that premise, then you are an extremist. You're trying to threaten everybody else's safety. So we see the tiptoe and march toward complete collectivism and mob rule and demosocracy, all backed by a technocratic component where everybody is tracked, traced, and surveilled. And if you don't follow policy and code, then you're deemed to be essentially an enemy combatant. As far as the Declaration of Independence goes, policy, statute, and code is only given the force of law through the consent of the governed. So we're being compelled to follow statute, policy, and code, but we have not been given full disclosure and notice, and we have not signed the contracts properly, right? So these folks are running around overthrowing God's law and the law of the land. They're not even banging on original principles. They're just out here harming themselves and each other, doing whatever they want to do. This is ubiquitous. All classes of society has lost their original mission statement and does not follow their principles and their own policy and code. They've just become completely reprobate, ego unbound. They're going to do whatever they want to do because they're going to chase money and they're going to chase status and power, and they've relinquished their original status and power straight from the supernatural. Any man or woman born on this land that does not uphold the original principles, precepts, and philosophy of law, because ignorance of the law is no excuse. You are damned to a form of spiritual judgment. I don't care if you think it's funny, you think it's a big joke. I'm telling you, the karmic and dharmic law of this realm, if you continue to create and stand on wrongdoing and defend it and enforce it, you're going to bring about demonic conditioning in this realm. You've already seen it. I don't know where you folks have been. We're already there. And you're damn well down with it. Most folks think it's just dandy.